far can we get if we sail a little bit high?
NFL Minneapolis app Case Keenum completed a last-ditch heave near the sideline Sunday on the game's final play, and Stephon Diggs slithered away for a 61-yard touchdown to give Minnesota a 29-24 victory over New Orleans and send the Vikings to the NFC Championship game, with one more win needed to become a first-time Super Bowl host. Drew Brees had driven the Saints in position for Will Lutz's go-ahead 43-yard field goal with 25 seconds remaining, punctuating a steely rally from a 17-point deficit that stood until 1:16 was left in the third quarter. The Vikings were out of timeouts and nearly out of options when Keenum dropped back with 10 seconds to go from his 39 and threw high into a crowd. Diggs jumped in front of Marcus Williams, WXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXX three touchdowns. Blake Bortles added 214 yards passing and a vital fourth quarter score as the relentless Jacksonville Jaguars stunned the Pittsburgh Steelers 45-42 on Sunday. Advertising in red invented by Teats, the third-seeded Jaguars will face top-seeded New England next week in Foxborough, Massachusetts after jumping on Pittsburgh early, then holding on late. Jacksonville raced to a 21-point lead, fended off a Steelers rally and responded every time Pittsburgh challenged. Ben Roethlisberger threw for 469 yards and set a franchise record with five touchdown passes but was also intercepted once and had a fumble return for a score. All-Pro Antonio Brown caught seven passes for 132 yards and two touchdowns in his return from a left calf injury. Le'Veon Bell had 155 yards of total offense and two scores. Philadelphia's defense staged a last-minute goal line stand and Jake Elliott atoned for a missed extra point with three field goals as the Eagles beat the Atlanta Falcons 15-10 Saturday to move into the NFC Championship game. Despite being underdogs as the number one seed, the Eagles showed plenty of moxie in the tightest spots of the fourth quarter. They stopped sixth-seeded Atlanta after it got to the 9 with a first down, and then on fourth down from the 2 when Matt Ryan's pass sailed over Julio Jones' head in the end zone. It was the first playoff win for Philadelphia since the 2008 season, and they will host Minnesota for the conference title next Sunday. Foxborough, Mass. App: Tom Brady passed for three touchdowns and 337 yards, and the New England Patriots cruised past the Tennessee Titans 35-14 on Saturday night to advance to the seventh consecutive AFC Championship game. It was Brady's 10th career postseason game with at least three TD tosses, moving him past Joe Montana for the most in NFL history. James White caught a touchdown pass and ran for another, and Danny Amendola had 11 catches for 112 yards. The Titans took an early 7-0 lead, but New England scored 35 straight points to take control. Marcus Mariota completed 22 of 37 passes for 254 yards and two touchdowns, but was under duress for most of the second half. He was sacked 8 times, a Patriots playoff record. Golf: Honolulu App: Patton Kizzy outlasted James Hahn in 6 extra holes to win the Sony Open to become the first multiple winner on the PGA Tour this season. Kizzy, who won the Old Classic in Mexico last fall, closed with a 2-under-68. That turned out to be the easy part. Hahn shot 62 in the final round Sunday and got into a playoff with Kizzy at 17-under-263. They matched two pars and two birdies on the par 5. 18th. They matched pars when they went to the par 3 17th. It ended on the par 3 along the Pacific Ocean when Hahn putted from right of the green to about 8 feet, and his par putt caught the lip. Honolulu App: Union workers for video and audio production at Golf Channel Events walked out Sunday over stalled contract negotiations, leading to limited coverage of the final round at the Sony Open and two other events in the Bahamas and Florida. Golf Channel said it has been negotiating an agreement for 9 months with International Alliance of Theatrical Stage Employees, a union for tournament technicians at golf tournaments, such as the camera crew. The strike involves only tournaments that Golf Channel produces. The network also produces the Career Builder Challenge next week in La Quinta, California. CBS Sports produces the following week at Torrey Pines, where Tiger Woods plays on the PGA Tour for the first time in a year. Orlando, Florida, App Scott Parrell beat fellow PGA Tour Champions player Scott Dunlap on the first hole of a playoff to complete the wire-to-wire victory in the Diamond Resorts Invitational. The 52-year-old Parrell won the 32-player professional division with a par on the extra hole, the 203-yard 18th at Tranquilo Golf Club. Dunlap hit a fat shot short into water and made a double bogey. In regulation, Dunlap made an 8-foot birdie putt for 3 points, and Parrell failed to get up and down and made a bogey to fall into the playoff. Unable to play a practice round before the event because of the flu, Parrell earned $125,000. Parrell and Dunlap finished with 93 points in the 54-hole modified Stableford event. Parrell earned 32 points in the final round, and Dunlap had 34. John Daly was third with 88. Five-time LPGA Tour winner Brooke Henderson, playing from the same tees as the men, was seventh with 80. College football Tuscan, Arizona. App Arizona has tabbed former Texas A&M coach Kevin Sumlin as its football coach. Sumlin is expected to sign a 5-year contract pending approval by the Arizona Board of Regents. An introductory news conference is scheduled for Tuesday. He replaces Rich Rodriguez, who was fired January 2 amid all harassment allegations. Sumlin was fired after 6 seasons at Texas A&M in November and had reportedly been in the mix for numerous jobs, including Arizona rival Arizona State. The Sun Devils hired former NFL coach and ESPN analyst Herm Edwards.